Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So today's topic is love for our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nahmadu nusalli ala rasulil kareem amma ba'd fa'uz billahi minash shaitan rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wahlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. So love for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, right perspective. Muslims all over the world love Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam dearly. He is respected not only among the Muslims, but many non-Muslims have also extolled him for his extraordinary qualities and the message he brought. But perhaps many are not aware of the fact that this love for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is in fact a necessary part of a Muslim faith, without which his very belief would be considered incomplete. That's the requirement of the Iman. So requirement of the Iman, when we say, Anas narrated, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, none of you will have faith till he loves me more than his father, his children and mankind. This is in Bukhari. Why has this love for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam been declared as a prerequisite for faith? Why must each and every believer love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than every other person in the world, even more than his own self? Because this love for last Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was meant to be the driving force for the believer to act upon each and every word and action of his beloved. So this love wasn't meant to be the selfish, stagnant, self-gratifying fairy tale emotion portrayed in the medium, but one that would propel a believer into action and change him from within and without. This love had to be stronger than any other love, stronger enough for a Muslim to sacrifice his family, wealth, his life and his own desire for the sake of this. So because it's a part of the religion, this is very love would not let the Muslims rest in peace until they had fulfilled the mission and convey the message that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had entrusted to them. Then why is it that we claim to love Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, yet his love has not brought about the same changes or results in our lives? How we can bring the changes? Let's see the signs of love for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We should first ask ourselves what kind of love Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam approved and what expression of love did he reject. Scholars have stated certain sign of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam love that can be summarized. Let me tell you few points. To have a strong desire to see and to be in the company of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to be ever ready to sacrifice one's life and wealth for the sake of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To obey Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam command and abstain for what he forbade. To support and favor Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sunnah and to defend the sharia that was revealed to him. There were certain expression of love that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explicitly disapproved. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not like that people should rise for him when he arrived. You understand, rise for him means you can't increase his status more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Narrated Abu Umama, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came out, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam came out to us leaning on a stick. We stood up to show respect to him. He said, do not stand up as foreigners do for showing respect to one another. This is in Abu Dawood. You know, they can show respect, but not in that way. Similarly, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam discouraged poetry that consists of shirk. What is shirk? Associating partners with Allah. And in some poetry or some people, they call it Naat. And they literally saying the words which are shirk. First of all, they call it with harfe nida. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ya is harfe nida and it is only called for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah is al-hayyul qayyum. He is always alive and he will be alive. ever living. But we can't tell to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi because he is no more in this world. Narrated Ar-Rawi, the daughter of Muaz bin Afra, after the consummation of my marriage, the Prophet ﷺ came and sat on my bed, as for me, as you are sitting now. Our little girl started beating the tambourines and reciting elegies verses, mourning my father who had been killed in the Battle of Badr. One of them said, among us is a prophet who knows that what will happen tomorrow. On that, Prophet ﷺ said, leave this saying and keep on saying the verse which you have been saying before. This is in Bukhari. So, sallallahu alaihi wasallam disliked excessive and exaggerated praise. Narrated by Umar radiallahu anhu, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, do not exaggerate in praising me, as Christians praise the son of Mary, for I am only a slave. So, call me the slave of Allah and his messenger. This is in Bukhari. He strongly condemned making his grave a place of worship or other deviant practices. And there is Aisha and Abdullah reported. Just a minute. There's a narration here. Aisha and Abdullah reported as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was about to breathe his last, he drew his sheet upon his face, and when he felt uneasy, he uncovered his face and said in that very state, let there be curse upon the Jews and Christians that they have taken the graves of their apostle as places of worship. He in fact warned this man against what they do, means Jews and Christians. This is in Muslim. So sadly, we do all the things which I mentioned before. So we should stop this. Love means obedience. Remember that. Love means obedience. Love means obedience and sacrifice. Allah Ta'ala lays down the criteria for his love in the Quran. Following the way of his messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, say, if you do love Allah, follow me. Allah will love you and forgive you your sins, for Allah is of forgiving and most merciful. This is mentioned in Surah Al-Ala Imran, ayah number 31. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu transmit that Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, all of my followers will enter paradise except those who have denied. He was asked, who has denied? He stated, whoever has obeyed me will enter Jannah. Whoever has disobeyed, has denied, will not enter Jannah. This is in Bukhari. True love for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam eyes was there for obedience to his sunnah and following his path. Where is this obedience in our lives today, in our, how obedience it should be. So when we, when Rabiul Awal comes, we think, we should gather and we should have poetry and we should celebrate his birthday. That's it. And we exaggerate his status. No, it's not so. Love him throughout the year. Why is it so? Because that is the part of the sunnah. That is the true love. So we shouldn't do any bidah. What is bidah? Innovation. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, has he celebrated any time his own birthday or any others? No. Let's not get into it. What is the clear-cut message? He never celebrated it. But you and many other, they celebrate it. I'm not pinpointing it anyone. I'm not targeting anyone. But I'm just saying generalized statement, like whoever is celebrating it. So they should stop that. Why is it so? Because we don't see any thing from Quran or Sunnah. If it is there, just present me. Let me see if you have that. We don't. So, whoever has performed a deed which is not in the religion from its inception is rejected, not acceptable to Allah. This is in Bukhari and Muslim. The companions who knew how to love, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu loved, the Quraysh of Makkah made a plot to murder Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah had given the order for migration to Medina. At night, in the cover of darkness, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu left Mecca and arrived at the cave Thor, where they decided to take refuge. The shoes of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu were worn out. Some said he used to walk tiptoe in order not to leave the trail behind him. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu first entered to explore the cave. You know, he went inside and make sure everything is okay. Be sure that it was safe. Closed all the holes with pieces torn off from his clothes, from his own clothes. Cleaned it. Then asked Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to step in. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam went in and immediately laid his head in Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu's lap and he fell asleep. Why is it so? Because he was so tired. Suddenly Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu's foot was stung by poisonous insect. They say scorpion. But he did not stir or move despite the severe pain he has, fearing Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam might wake up. So this was in the seal nectar, how his love was. We should have that kind of love, that kind of itaat. And the human shield of Sahaba, it has been reported on the authority of Anas bin Malik that when the enemy got the upper hand on the day of battle of Uhud, the messenger of Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when the enemy advanced towards him and overwhelmed him, he said, "Who turns them away from us will attain paradise, will be companions in a paradise." A man from the Ansar came forward and fought the enemy until he was killed. The enemy advanced and overwhelmed him. Again, he repeated the words, "Who turns them away from us will attain paradise, will be my companion in paradise." A man from Ansar came forward and fought until he was killed. This state continued until seven Ansar were killed. How many? Seven. One after another. This is in Muslim. After the martyrdom of seven Ansari in Uhud, two Quraysh were left guarding Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Tala bin Ubaidullah and Saad bin Abi Waqas. These two Sahabas bravely fought the Quraysh and use their own bodies as shields to protect Allah's Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Such was their love for him. Narrated Faiz, I saw Talas paralyzed and with which he had protect the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam on the day of Uhud, and this is in Bukhari. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was left with Tala bin Ubaidullah and Saad bin Abi Waqqas for only a few seconds before other Sahaba arrived to shield him. And Abu Dujana radiallahu anhu made himself a shield for Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Arrow kept on striking his back, yet he continued to bend over Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam to protect him. And in end, many arrows pierced his back. So that's how the love was. Inshallah, we'll continue in the next class. We'll stop here.